Ladies and gentlemen, it's November 26th, my name is Crowmoore, and welcome back to This is the Police 2. Last time wasn't such a nice episode. We managed to lose three of our good men, and also we almost lost our MVP Flower Pots. She just barely escaped with her life. But we also got some new people joining in.
Thank you again for your time, Mr. Kogan.
Oh, shit.
And thanks for your patience. Next Thursday, we'll have another meeting, by which time I will have some new questions for you. If you remember something new before our next meeting, not just about Jack Boyd, but about your work in the police department as a whole, then just let me know. If you change your work schedule, let me know. If you need to leave Freeburg for some reason, well, you understand. Let me know.
Don't look at me, Mr. Kogan. I don't want to be here any more than you do. If it was up to me, neither one of us
Thank
would
you again,
to.
Mr. Kogan. You are free to go.
Who was that guy? I don't remember.
Take it easy on these people, Lana. They don't have
to. I'm just doing my job, Wilton. It's your job too, remember? Please invite Miss Emma Weinstein in.
Emma Weinstein? Again? What is this already, her sixth?
Just the fourth.
And you're hoping to learn something new. As far as I recall, she just keeps saying the same thing.
I will definitely learn something new, Wilton. Even if she keeps saying the same thing. Even the fact that she always repeats all the answers word for word. That's already very important information just by itself.
Well, yes, for you. Because the whole world around you is very important information.
I really don't know what's going on. Who are these people?
Good morning, Miss Weinstein. I'll ask you some questions, some of them new, others I've already asked you during previous interviews. But I hope that you'll be kind enough to...
You can ask me any questions, Miss Thurman. I'll answer you. For the second time, the fifth, the tenth, as long as it takes. You know that.
Then let's not waste any time.
Oh shit, we need to do an interrogation. But yeah, before this cutscene happened, I was saying that we got some new people joining our forces, so that's cool. And we also have these two ongoing investigations. I really don't know what to do about them, because our investigators are shit. Basically, no one seems to find any clues, or just some weird clues. I don't really know what to do with them. But does that make me a bad cop? It might. But yeah, let's see what's going on here. How many years have you been Jack Boyd's secretary? So Jack Boyd is the Geralt of Sharpwood. For as long as he was... As he was police chief. 12 years. Why do I get to answer to these questions? What's going on? Let's say for as long as he was police chief. From his first day on duty to his last. I'm sure you can find all the dates in your records. Okay. How would you describe the nature of your work? I did everything a personal assistant should do. I handled everything so that Mr. Boyd could concentrate on his work. I did everything a personal assistant should do. Calls, meetings, schedules, coffee, paperwork. Nothing special. Did Mr. Boyd ever ask you to do anything illegal? I'm not a lawyer. No. Jack Boyd guarded the law and didn't break it. Yeah, we are defending Geralt. Do you know anything about his goal to earn $500,000 before he retired? No. I don't know anything about that, but as far as I can tell, he never lived like he had any money. Do you know of any case when Jack Boyd may have contacted a representative? God. Damn it, those words. Of Freeburg's criminal underworld. Yes, but that was part of his job. I don't know. Okay, let's give them something. Sometimes you need to get in touch with one criminal to track down another criminal. I'm sure you know about these things better than I do. Well, don't count on it. These people are pretty bad police officers. Have you had any contact with him since he was placed on the federal wanted list? No, that would be illegal. No. The last time I saw Jack Boyd was on his last day of work. Ever since then, I haven't heard anything from him. Way to go, lady. Do you think Jack Boyd is guilty of the crimes he's been accused of? No. I know that he's not guilty of anything. He was framed, he was tricked. He's the victim in the whole sad story. We have information that you have visited Jack Boyd's children at least 3 times in the past 6 months. Can you say anything in your defense? I'm just trying to help them. The boys were left without parents, their mother left them, and their father was turned into a scapegoat. If you think that I need to justify myself for having a little human sympathy, you're definitely crazy. Yeah. Nice. If the court decided to listen to your phone calls and read your correspondence during the course of this investigation, how would you feel about that? Who would like it? I don't care. I have nothing to hide. If our prosecutor's office has nothing more to do than listen to conversations of a poor woman who spends most of the day taking care of her sick mother, then please have your fun with our taxes. God will be your judge. Oh shit, nice one. Thank you. Oh shit, Penkin, once again. I want to fire him, but I can't. I just can't do it. Mr. Nash, our concert was a success. Lenny drummed so hard that he broke 3 pairs of sticks. My cousins yelled and danced, and my wife says she wants the same show for her sisters. But it will be in the spring. Meanwhile, I am completely at your disposal. Let's go catch some bad guys. Oh shit, did Penkin came to work? My god. Excellent. So that means that we can fire him. Let's see how good he is. If he's a sucky cop, then I think we should fire him. Although we need the man force. God damn it. Hard decisions. The drunk. Mr. Nash, today is the funeral of Pierce Rosencrantz. I want to go honor the memory of a good cop. Could you let me go for a couple of hours? Well, we want to honor him, but we also need people on the streets. No, we are running a tight shop here. No, you cannot go. Mr. Nash, today is the funeral of Benedict Belmont. I want to go honor the... Oh, shit. No, nobody goes to the funeral. We have bad guys to catch. Oh my god, no. Right. Okay, we have a semi-good roster here. But think about what would have happened if I let everyone to go to the funeral. I would have like... Who? Penkin. Penkin with the rate of 10. God damn it. That would have been awful. Let's auto-assign stuff. Yeah, looks just about right. Yeah, okay. Okay, the secret of the pink chewing gum. We need most likely the intelligence dudes here. But unfortunately, pretty much everyone is stupid as a potato. Except Shinny. But Shinny is a... I don't think we can afford to put her to the investigation. I don't even know what we get if we solve these investigations. Do we have any reason to actually solve this? Do we care that somebody stole a VCR? Actually, I'm not going to assign anyone here. Let's do them later. We have more... What? There's an open case with no cop assigned to it. If you leave things like this, no progress will be made today. Are you sure you want to continue? Yes. We have more important things to do than trying to find a old VCR. This morning they buried Ricky Gassman. It was a modest but worthy ceremony for those closest to him. Oh, Gassman, he was a beast. Oh, what's this? Natasha Rosencrantz. Oh shit, is this Rosencrantz's wife? I'll tell you what you are, Mr. Warren Nash. You're a miserable, ugly toad. Pierce Rosencrantz always talked about you. But now he's not going to say another word because you killed him. Well, technically, I did not kill him. It was the bad guys and also the shitty sniper who didn't do anything when he was in trouble. Right. It was your idiotic orders that sent him to his grave. God damn it. You're the one who turned our quiet police station into a stinking morgue. I never thought I'd become a widow so soon, or that our family would lose its breadwinner and my son would be left without his father. Oh, I could just grab you by the throat and never let go, but I need to think about my son. Pierce always wanted to give him a good education so that he could escape this hole of a town one day. But my husband is gone, so now it's up to you to pay for my son's college dreams. Give me $2,000 right now, or I'll raise such a scandal you'll never recover. Well, you're not gonna blackmail me.
534 in progress.
Also, they buried Belmont. Okay, nobody from his family is going to what's the word? Like accuse us for killing him. Alright, child abuse. Once again at the Astrid E. Johnson High School. A girl found a hedgehog and brought it to school in a bag. Her teacher tried to confiscate it and throw the hedgehog away, but the girl swung the bag at him and hit his leg. The hedgehog's spines tore the teacher's trousers and he became angry. He grabbed a ruler and intends to teach the schoolgirl a lesson. Okay, I think... Let's see what Penkin can do. Oh shit, we need 315, so Penkin is not doing much here. Let's also send Galilahi. And maybe Spurlock. Is that enough? That's just right. We are not going to send in the sniper to shoot down the hedgehog. Of course he's not going to shoot anybody because he's such a shitty sniper. Nash, I'm not going to mess around babysitting losers like Kevin Penkin. Oh my... Give me a normal partner, a professional. Okay, actually... I think we are just going to fire Penkin. We'll give Miradian here. Is that okay? Oh god damn it! Who do you want? Gildenstern? Oh for fuck's sake, Spurlock! I'm going... Oh... But now we don't actually... Yeah, we don't need Galilahi here. Is that okay? Can you deal with that? God damn it. So yeah, should we fire, actually... Penkin? Or is this some sort of Easter egg? Because he seems shitty. He's never at work. And... But does he have, like, some... huge XP bonus that if he manages to do something, he gains like a million levels or something like that. Should we just fire him? No, not yet. Let's look how he does. Hopefully we don't get any big shootings today. I really don't want to lose any more people. Apollo's Toast Cafe. There's an assault. A woman was waiting a long time for her order and finally she couldn't take it anymore and attacked the waitress with an empty tray she grabbed from the stack. Doesn't sound too bad. 590! Okay. So let's send in Mustard, Penkin, and... Oh, it's just not enough. This seems... no. We don't want to send four people to handle stuff like that. We'll send in Sullivan. And Penkin is just there for good measure. Alright, we are at the child abuse scene. A teacher with a large ruler is chasing after a girl along the corridor, screaming, "My father gave me his pants. They are all I have left to remember him by." The girl is carrying a bag containing a hedgehog. When she sees the officer, she rushes towards him. Take down the teacher with a swift baton strike, grab the girl's hedgehog and hit the teacher with it, shield the girl. I think we can... Yeah, Spurlock can hit the teacher with a baton. Boink! The cop stopped the teacher with the sharp baton strike. He fell down and burst into tears, his trousers now quite ruined. The schoolgirl and her hedgehog are no longer in any danger. Excellent job. Well done, Spurlock. Okay, Rubara got some levels. So... Maybe... yeah, let's give him speed. As Spurlock will be getting negotiation skills. Excellent. I'm still not sure if we should do it like the jack of all trades approach, or should we just put some guy like that he's just awesome at shooting but sucks at everything else. I think the jack of all trades approach is it's just quite fine. A suspicious package from Jessica Shinny. Mr. Nash, there's two strange boxes tied up with twine on the table in the foyer. We asked all the guys, no one knows what's in them or who brought them. To be honest, we are afraid to open them. You must have heard, a couple months ago someone sent a bomb to the Liningville police station. Well, now it looks like they suddenly decided to send two bombs at once. So what do you think? What do you think it is? Some kind of poisonous powder? What are we going to do now? You may take them home. take them to my office. Alright, we got some cigarettes. Excellent. And some tuna. More and more junk is piling up outside your office. If you don't find any storage space in the near future, your subordinates may start asking uncomfortable questions. Where do we get storage space? I have no idea. Do we have any... God damn it! I'm still angry about the sniper who didn't do anything to help our poor mates. We have harassment at courthouse. A girl came in for an interview and the count clerk demanded sex from her in exchange for a job. Doesn't sound too hard. We'll be sending in the drunk. No, Spurlock will not go with the drunk, so... Galilahi and... Yeah, this seems okay. I wonder if we can actually send the sniper in. A woman with a shaved head is strangling a waitress. This is the restaurant assault. Yeah, okay. So, a woman with a shaved head is strangling a waitress, pushing a serving tray against her throat. Another food tray is lying on the wet floor. Strike the woman with a baton, tackle the woman, grab a tray and hit the woman. Maybe we should... No, in order to tackle her, we most likely need some speed. We could send Sullivan in with the baton. Yeah, let's do that.
The cop stuns the woman with a baton strike. When she comes to herself, she shamefully says that she didn't mean to harm the waitress. I'm just not myself when I'm hungry. That's no excuse. Alright. What's next? I think we arrived at the courthouse.
Yes.
The count clerk is aggressively grabbing the girl's hand and refuses to let go. We can order him to release the girl, but... Well, Misika has some negotiation skills. Shoot the clerk with the taser, restrain the clerk. In order to restrain him, we need strength, I think. Should we just shoot him with a taser? We don't have actually any good shooters either. Let's order him to release the girl.
540 complete.
Yes!
He obeys, lets the girl go, and surrenders.
Fabulous.
Meridian, oh, the drunk got a level. Well, he's usually drunk, so we will not be giving him any shooting skills. But... maybe he's a fast drunk. Or a negotiating drunk.
Yes.
This is going great. Nobody has died. We have only buried three dudes that died previously. But in this episode, no one has died. So... I would say that's a victory. Oh shit! Attempted murder. What the what? At the Thomas Piccoli's mill, an elderly woman was frightened by a child with a revolver, which he is aiming at passersby.
I have no idea where the 10 years gets a revolver from, but one thing I know for sure: this is going to end badly.
Right, and let me guess, it's a toy gun. It must be a toy gun. But we will be sending Shinny in just in case. And maybe... Spurlock? That's just enough. My Charlie's Angels. Should we send the sniper? No, we are not going to send the sniper. What the what? Nash, we talked about it and decided that we are not going anywhere. We just rather play cards. What the fuck? Oh, I really don't wanna fire Shinny. She's like second to best to flower pots. As Mustard is not going with a woman. God damn it, these people. Actually, Mustard can go all by himself. Okay, do it. And we also have an assault at the registry office. A young man and his girlfriend were trying to register a marriage without an appointment. When the officer refused, the groom lost his temper and started attacking the office employees. Alright, so Shinny, would you like to go there, maybe, with Spurlock? Oh, for fuck's sake. So, Kurosawa, it's you and Spurlock.
What?
Why is... everyone wants to just play cards? What is this madness? Misika? And Sullivan? No? Did Sullivan just say he wants to play cards? No, I really don't know what's going on. But that's nothing new. That's like my normal way of being. Completely clueless. A man has grabbed an elderly registry office employee by the hair and is smashing her face on the table. Shoot the guy with the taser. Stab the guy with the big knife. Oh, that's kinda brutal. Man, you really want to get married that badly. We will be using our taser. Although Misika sucks at shooting. Hopefully he doesn't hit the clerk. Do it.
Yes!
The registry office employee has a broken nose, but she'll leave.
Excellent.
Good job. We will now give you some shooting skills. Gratitude from Donna Ferry. Mr. Nash, today I turned out to be an unwitting witness to a horrible crime where innocent lives were hanging in the balance. It was a pleasure seeing the cops working under your leadership. Everybody always said that the cops here just hang around, policing their patches. Well, they used to. But after what I saw today, I have no doubt that true professionals work at your department. I have 4 children myself, and I'd just die if something happened to my bunnies. Thank you for your work. I want to really thank you in some way. I work as a cleaner, and I could at least straighten up the station for you. I won't mess with anyone or touch anyone's things. I'll just polish everything up, so you won't even recognize the place. Just point me to a bucket and some water. Is this some sort of a hoax? Is she... Although we do need to get rid of some boxes that we, for some reason, can't carry out for ourselves, so we are going to hire Donna Ferry to take those out for us. What's next? A bomb threat! Oh my god, and we also have disorderly conduct. At the city center, a naked old man with a whip is trying to direct traffic in the center of town. Okay, naked old man. This sounds like a job for Shinny. I want to punish her for not doing her job. And Miradian. Kalilahi. Is this okay? It's okay. Okay, now Shinny wanted to go. She just wants to see the naked old man. Warehouse. A worker at the Pluto Vancouver warehouse claims that the other guys got tired of always getting paid late and decided to arrange a strike. But when the owner didn't bow to their demands, they escalated the situation. They are getting ready to blow up a stock of old sticks of dynamite to attract the owner's attention. Oh, maybe Shinny should have been here. We'll send in Misika. Gross up. Cops who dislike you will not obey your orders during tactical operations. They are sure that they know better than you what they should do and how. Oh, fuck, so... How to tell who's loyal to you and who isn't? Easy, loyal cops wear police hats. Oh! Okay. Well, then we are pretty much fucked here. Because I denied all these guys the access to the funeral. So we only have Misika, Rubara, Guildenstern, and this goddamn sniper. Can we send in Penkin? Maybe. If Penkin gets killed, who cares? As Burlock is not going. Or is she? Okay. Okay, Penkin actually went there. So, this is a tactical situation, like in the last episode. So, the chances are that we are losing some people here. The child was playing bandit with a toy gun. He doesn't pose any threat for now. I knew it. And... cops have arrived at the crime scene. Oh, Jesus Christ. Oh, no. A bomb threat. Warehouse. Let's see who we have here. We don't have anything to bribe these people with. Dyson MacArthur. Trucker from Ripton. I thought I was gonna be taken hostage, but somehow I miraculously escaped the warehouse. Oh, we can actually trade the cigarettes to him. Owner of a dog named Pie, warehouse worker. I know where the bomb is in the warehouse. Should we bribe him? These guys are idiots. They don't think that they think that the explosion won't be so powerful because the explosives are old. The main thing is just not to get near the bomb. In fact, stay as far away from it as you can. Old dynamite becomes unstable. Those rednecks, I tried to explain it to them, but They just told me to shut up and get out of their way. I was just thinking, if they blow everything up, then I'll have to look for a new job. But if you arrest those half-assed bombers, I will probably get a promotion. So let me show you where the guys put the bomb. Although, on the other hand, maybe I shouldn't tell you. What if the cops go and blow themselves up? Well, that's a possibility. I mean, it's highly likely that that's going to happen. Meanwhile, I got my ass hanging out. No work, not a penny in my pocket. If only I had some boots. The local pawn shop always gives a good deal on them. I can eat canned soup for the half a year before I die. Okay, let's trade him and have him tell us where the bomb is. The detonator is in the room with the forklift. If you are going to neutralize the bomb, it's better to take a brainy guy with knowledge of explosives. Otherwise, there's a chance that the warehouse will turn into a mass grave. We are not going to talk to these other people. I think we are fucked either way. So now what I want to know is that has the game saved? Because this would be an excellent time to end this episode. So let's just say that the game saved and end it here. And we'll get... because I have a good reason for this. Because we don't want to lose people in two episodes in a row. So if we leave the dying to next episode, everything is fine. Well, not everything, but it will be better than two episodes in a row. So, thanks for watching and let's see you at the bomb site in the next episode. Bye-bye!